additional thing that I leveraged when I was working at the bank. The bank I worked for was known for tons of meetings that just went on too long.
If they want to call a meeting, make sure that they too have an agenda. Have them email you prior what they plan to cover. This way you have a roadmap, a direction to go for that meeting. Otherwise, you may not even cover what you wanted to talk about in the first place because things just kind of go all over the place. Have you thought of, from this exercise, maybe some ways that you can go back and try and create a win-win?
I put it on my big rock list, so I don't know that I really figured it out, but at least to schedule some time to try to figure it out.
Okay, very good. A lot of people look at think win-win like that's where you come up with your solution, when indeed, when we're saying think win-win, it's state of mind. It's not until we seek to understand that person and we can be understood that we can synergize and come up with that third alternative solution. So for this step, it's just more of a mentality type of thing. Just think it, not necessarily come up with a solution. You just have to be more open-minded. We are now doing the time matrix activity, and basically what we did was we divided the room into four groups based on the four different quadrants, quadrant one, quadrant two, quadrant three, and quadrant four. So what I had them do was basically make three lists to list out if they were living the life as a quadrant one person, what activities they would be participating in, what feelings would come from those activities, as well as a long-term impact on those activities. Now, quadrant one, or things more or less, we don't necessarily have control of. You can't help if your kid gets sick or if you get a flat tire. So there's a catchphrase with FranklinCovey, and they say, live above the line, which means you want to spend a majority of your time above this line right here. You definitely want to avoid quadrants three and four. You know, preferably quadrant two, of course, but there are going to be cases where we can't help the flat tire. But, you know, maybe if we're well prepared, you have AAA or, you know, other things to kind of help you out when you face those quadrant one situations, we can definitely have more control of our results.
But maybe what I'm thinking I'm going to do for this upcoming month is, rather than spiffing that person top coordinator $350, maybe I take and give him 100 of it and spend 250 for everybody in the room if everybody can hit X amount of goal and higher to get them to be more of a team. Maybe throw them a pizza party or take them all out to lunch or whatever it is that could try and develop that team goal back.
So instead of giving everything just to him or taking it away from the department as a whole, you're actually going to reward everyone.
Everybody.
So you create a third alternative.
Yeah.
Very good. What we're going to do now is begin the creation of your mission statement. You don't obviously just make it in a few minutes like we have here today. So we're just going to get you started. You know, a mission statement takes hours, weeks, you know, maybe years to make. And you're going to go back from time to time and look at your mission statement and find that your circumstances may have changed and you're going to adjust that accordingly. Okay. How many people in here were having a conversation with someone and they wanted to say something and decided not to and later on said, thank goodness I didn't say that, right? Carla's raising her hand up real high.
I have all kinds of things to say.
And how many people have here have not thought before they said something and then later on when they calm down, they're like, oh.
I'm
yeah. Okay.
This is like your stimulus and your response. But between stimulus and response, there's a space. And that's where your freedom to choose is. And that's where STEP comes into place, S-T-E-P. So basically, that's an acronym for stop, take a step back, evaluate, and then proceed. So it's a good way to kind of, when you're facing a situation where you're not quite sure how to respond, or you know, you don't want to be reactive, you can keep that acronym in mind and that'll guide you. So if you look for commitment one, and Jill had given an example of what she's going to do today to try and be proactive, a situation that she was going to be facing. So if everyone could just take, you know, maybe 30 seconds or so, just think of something that you could do today or something that you're going to be facing today that you know, you can approach it in a proactive way and just list it there. Mentally, you imagine that you're going to do something first, right? You envision it first. And it's not just going to happen on its own. Just because you thought of it, it's not going to exist. So you need to physically make that occur. Okay, guys, the word is trust. The word is trust. So please write down as many words you can think of associated with the word trust. How many did you end up?
Well, we exceeded our projections. We had the smallest group, so we're very even.
What I want you to do on day 5 is select a relationship in your life that could use mutual understanding. Basically, have a conversation with them where you're using empathic listening.
How can you brainstorm? How can you create other options without diminishing your own interest as well?
I think if you're a positive role model with it, and maybe they see how you're trying to approach the situation, they may be more open-minded to coming up with an alternative solution, you know, a better situation.
I just want you to think about a challenge that you face at work or in your personal life. And in the circles below, you're going to write the things that the challenge falls within your circle, whether you actually have influence over it or if it's just a concern that you have. So if you could please work together on that, we'll give you a few minutes.
Lincoln, if you could please describe some activities that your team has chosen, as well as the feelings and the long-term impact, please.
One of the activities was making payroll. Feelings makes you anxious, leads to high blood pressure.